क्योंकि ही इज अ लकी चार्म फॉर एनी अलायंस.
Hello and welcome to nationalkhabar.com. On the show today, we have with us the Member of Parliament from Jamui and the Chirag of Lok Janashakti Party, Chirag Paswan. Welcome to the show, Chirag.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
So, upcoming Lok Sabha polls. What are the strategies? How are you going to handle it?
No strategy in particular. I mean, like last time, we contested the elections with an alliance in NDA with Bharatiya Janata Party, and even this time also, the coming Lok Sabha elections, we're going to be the part of NDA only, and we'll contest the elections in this alliance only. And I'm pretty sure, you know, the way Modi government has worked in the past 4 years now, and by the time we reach elections, it's going to be 5 years. So I think. Development being our agenda, and that going to continue as the prime focus, as the prime agenda, not only of the alliance but of our party as well. So yeah, I mean, that is it. Nothing else.
What are the chances of NDA from Bihar? What do you see?
Oh, there are superb chances again, and especially with Nitish's party joining, coming back in our alliance. We are much stronger than what we were in 2014, particularly in Bihar. We are much stronger than what we were in 2014. That time Nitish wasn't there with us, and it was a triangular fight. RJD was contesting separately, and JDU was separate, and our alliance was BJP and LJP and Rashtriya Lok Samta Party. We were contesting under one alliance. So this time Nitish is also there in an alliance with us. And so yeah, that gives me the confidence that our alliance is much stronger than what it was in 2014. We managed to get 31 out of 40 seats in our alliance, and I think this time it's going to be a clean sweep. 40 out of 40 we're
going to
win.
But isn't it going to be a complex thing, the seat sharing thing?
It won't be, actually. I mean, yes, I mean, it's been something that's been a lot talked about, and it's just an assumption. People are perceiving it in a way that because Janata Dal United, again a big regional party from our state, is there in the alliance, so definitely seat sharing going to be an issue and stuff. But I don't really think. I think the only factor for all the parties under this alliance, especially in Bihar, will be the winnability. Winnability will be the biggest factor. So any seat, I think any political party, whether it's Lok Jan Shakti Party, our party, or Janata Dal United, whosoever takes it, winnability will be the prime focus. And our target would be that all 40 seats, our alliance should win. Who's winning, who's getting more number of seats, JDU is getting how many seats, or we are getting how many seats, that won't be a concern.
But it matters, because in last election also there was disappointment from LJP side.
We were during Vidhan Sabha, not during Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha we were pretty satisfied. During Vidhan Sabha, yes, there were few concerns. But those issues were different. Our concerns were not that we got less number of seats in Vidhan Sabha or anything of that sort. Our concerns were the formula that we were told. And I made it very public and very categorically. I came on record to say all these things, that I was a little shocked because we were told a different formula, and the way the seats were shared between the allies, as in Rashtriya Lok Samta Party and Lok Jan Shakti Party, and that time Maji was also there with us, so with Maji Ji's party. So we were told a different formula, but when the seats were announced, they were a little different. So I was a little shocked concerning that. For us, I'll say this with the utmost authority, being the chairman of the parliamentary board, number of seats has never been a concern for me. But definitely, yes, where our party has a stronghold, that matters to me.
When you say number of seats is never a matter of concern for LJP, what are the issues that are a matter of concern?
Winnability, as I said, that's the most important. Like, I don't want to take seats just for the heck of contesting, you know. If I am not sure, The particular seat doesn't have a stronghold of our party there, or our cadre base is not that strong. I would not want to take it just for the number's sake, you know. I was so happy that in Lok Sabha election, you know, we got 7 seat, and out of 7 we managed to win 6 seat. So the strike rate matters to me instead of the number.
So after this issue of Lalu Prasad Yadav being convicted, do you think the sympathies will go with him? It will flow with him, the Muslim Yadav consolidation together?
No, I don't think so. I mean, Laluji is not behind the bars. He wasn't a freedom fighter that, you know, sympathy going to go with him. He is there for under corruption charges. And the people of Bihar knows this pretty well. This was one of the biggest ghotala way back in 90s. And so, yeah, he's been charged for that, and he's behind bar for corruption. So there's, I don't think there's any reason for anyone to give sympathy to him concerning this. Having said that, as I said, our alliance is strong. Nitishji has done some very good work in the state over the years. He's been there over a decade as the Chief Minister of Bihar. So he has done a good work, and even at the center level. So I think under the leadership of Narendra Modi ji at the center level, and the leadership of Nitish Kumar ji at the state level, our alliance is strong, and that will help us win the coming Lok Sabha also.
Now, when we talk of LGP as a party, we see that it has remained a regional party. It has never become strong to be a national party. What are the reasons? Do you have any aims to do so?
Of course, yes. I mean, I would want to expand the party at a much bigger level, and that is one thing that I am personally working on, trying to expand the party roots to various other states. In Jharkhand, our party has become really strong now. UP this time also in Vidhan Sabha election, we wanted to contest because our party holds a strong hold, yeah, even in Uttar Pradesh. There was a time when we had almost 17 MLAs coming from Uttar Pradesh. So this time also we wanted, but the adjustment in terms of seat sharing couldn't happen then. But yes, I mean, in coming years, I do see Lok Jan Shakti Party expanding in various other states, especially the adjoining states of Bihar. Also, we have a good hold in Northeast. We have a MLA in Manipur. He's in the cabinet there. He's a minister there in Manipur. So even in Northeast also, we have a good hold. Down South also in Tamil Nadu.
No, you mentioned first name was Uttar Pradesh. When you say Uttar Pradesh, 22% of Dalit vote. But your party was never involved for campaigning. What was the reason?
No, it wasn't that our party was not involved. Our national president went there to campaign for BJP because we were not contesting. I was there. I was campaigning in various districts of Uttar Pradesh during Vidhan Sabha election. So yeah, but eventually, yes, though we are part of alliance, but yes, I have my own party, and I would want that in coming, if not Lok Sabha, then definitely in coming Vidhan Sabha elections, whether it's Uttar Pradesh or various other states where our party holds a stronghold, we would want to contest.
And it is always blamed that Lok Jan Shakti Party promotes dynasty politics.
I'm the outcome of that, so I can't deny that. But having said, I don't think anybody can promote dynasty politics. You know, I mean, eventually you are at a public domain, you know, and it's the people of the country, you know, either, you know, they'll support you or they'll, you know, throw you out. So when you're there in public domain, I don't think anyone can thirst you in that domain. Maybe I can get an easy entry because of the lineage that I come from. But to sustain there and to take it on a higher level, eventually everything will boil down to my capabilities, my potential. If I won't be having that potential, I don't think it's going to work.
No, with two of your uncles, your cousin, you, so are you following the footsteps of Lalu Prasad?
I have no one right now to follow anybody's footstep. I mean, yeah, at the end of the day, our national president takes all these calls. Having said that, I remember even during Vidhan Sabha election, you know, this was very strongly thrown on us that, you know, we are promoting a lot of family members into elections and stuff. I would want to say this, we contested 42 Vidhan Sabha seats, and only 3 members, including my cousin, only 3 members of the family contested they were contesting the elections. Rest 39 of them were there out and out on their merit. So, you know, when you say that only family members are there, I think somewhere we forget and we don't give the due to the other party workers. You know, 39 of them, they manage only on their own. So I think their due is not given when we just talk about family. Yes, family do gets highlighted because of various reasons. But as I said, it's not about the family, it's about the potential in you. If you have it, you'll make it. If you don't have it, you'll not be able to.
No, with you being in LJP, your cousin being in LJP, it looks as if the party is trying to promote youth to come up and hold the reins of the party. Is it true?
Of course, yes. I mean, I also would want that, and not only youth from my family, I mean, I would want youth across the country to join with our party. Even in the party also, I try to promote a lot of young faces. I try to give them a lot of responsibility at the organizational level. And definitely, you know, when youth come forward, they come with a lot of new ideas. You know, they are more enthusiastic and stuff. Experience definitely counts. So yeah, I mean, there need to be a good balance of seniors' experience and the youngsters coming in with new ideas.
And this question is always raised, that Ram Vilas Paswan, come what may, wants a ministry for himself. Whosoever is running the government, it doesn't matter. What do you feel about it?
I think I'll take it as a compliment. I don't know whether it's a criticism. I would want to take it as a compliment that wherever our national president goes under an alliance, that alliance comes through power. And repeatedly we have seen, you know, way back when we were there in NDA during Atalji's time, that time when he joined. And I would want to make this very clear and on record that we have never ever had a post-poll alliance. It's always been a pre-poll alliance.
So but you mean to say he's lucky for...
Lucky, yes. I would want to use that word. I think he's a lucky charm for any alliance. Last time also when we joined... NDA in 2014. That time also it was promoted in this way only.
He is that visionary, he is able to see which party is going to win.
Maybe, yeah, he is experienced. I mean, it's over almost 50 years in politics. So definitely experience counts. But having said that, yes, this is what I was saying, that we have always had the pre-poll alliance. We never went for post-poll. Not that this particular alliance is coming to power, so we're going to support them. It's always been a pre-poll alliance. And when we were with UP also, or when we came with NDA, or during Atalji's time also. So it's always been a pre-poll alliance.
Thank you so much for talking with us. So Chirag Paswan was on show with us. Thank you for watching nationalkhabar.com.